Hola muchachos, soy yo, Juaco Producciones X. Recién he despertado esta mañana, así que pensé en ver un video, una reacción. No, voy a reaccionar a un video. Esta vez será la de Asfato, Screw Attack. Será Dante del Devil May Cry versus Bayonetta de Bayonetta. Vamos. 1, 2, 3.
This episode of Death Battle is brought to you by Angry Video Game Nerd 2, Assimilation. Pre-order on Steam right now to save...
Yo solo veré Angry Video Game Nerd.
For some action heroes, it's not enough to just save the world. They've gotta look good doing it. Dante, the Devil Hunter. And Bayonetta, the Umbra Witch. He's Wiz and I'm Boomstick. And it's our job to analyze their weapons, armor, and skills to find out who would win
a death battle.
Down Slum Avenue, and you'll find all sorts of hangouts for the scum of the underworld. The Bullseye Bar, a random strip club, and even a rundown service shop called Devil May Cry. But the services they're selling aren't like washing your car or fixing your plumbing. Oh no! Long as you got the cash, this shop specializes in delivering demonic beatdowns. Who's crazy enough to try making a living this way, you ask? His name is
Dante.
From the very beginning, Dante's life was always unusual. Born from the unholy union of a
medio de nemo, medio demonio, completamente increíble.
Hijo
de Esparta.
El genio. With his mother gone and his brother assumed dead, Dante was left with only one option. Become the ultimate demon hunter and perpetuate the cycle of vengeance. This party's getting crazy. Let's rock. Despite the dangerous nature of his occupation, Dante always maintains a carefree spirit while dispatching devils of the underworld.
It's part of his charm. Hell, when you've got abilities like Dante's, why not be a little cocky? He's faster than the mortal eye can see, strong enough to grapple with the underworld's toughest demons, and
super fuerza, se recupera, se teletransporta.
That's thanks to his regenerative ability. In fact, all of that is made possible due to his demonic heritage, and made even more deadly by his plethora of weapons. His favorites being his dual pistols and enormous sword.
Like any proud weapon owner, he gives his tools of destruction pet names. His guns, ebony and ivory,
special
great shots and
jackpot.
Respectively. These hand cannons are so powerful, they can eat and obliterate demons in a single shot.
I think that looks you better.
Rebellion is a large magical sword given to him by...
That's como una pistola dorada de GoldenEye.
Dante also collected a wide assortment of additional weaponry called Devil Arm. Physical manifestations of powerful demons he has defeated.
Remember Mega Man? Steroids.
His arm is
gigantic.
And striking power, letting him shatter huge monoliths with a lethal one-inch punch.
With Lucifer, the backpack, not the devil, Dante basically throws infinite lightsabers. He's also got an electric guitar, which is literally electric. From a giant Beyblade to a flying turret gun. Where does he possibly keep all this stuff?
Really, really deep pockets. Or perhaps it's one of his styles, abilities he's also acquired from defeating demon bosses. With doppelganger style, he can duplicate himself. With trickster style, he can teleport instantly. With royal guard style, he becomes a nigh impervious dreadnought. And he can even slow down time with the quicksilver style.
On the rare occasion Dante feels he needs to get serious, he enters the Devil Trigger, a transformation which taps into his demonic heritage.
well-armed, Dante is more than capable of handling entire hordes of demons on his own. Although this doesn't stop some of his allies from joining him from time to time. This includes Trish, a demon lady who occasionally fights alongside him, and happens to resemble his deceased mother. Talk about giving somebody an Oedipus complex.
Hey, if I may quote an old family saying, if she's not directly related, she's safe to be dated.
That explains a lot. Luckily, and quite surprisingly, that...
Pensando que Boomstick se va a casar con ella.
Thank God. Dante is a working, talking feeder chief.
Más bien va a querer hacerlo.
One time after getting impaled by four demons at once, he pushed one so hard it exploded and dropped a ceiling fan on the other three. All while eating a slice of pizza. Oh, when their friend showed up, he challenged them to a game of billiards. He won.
Dante has run down the side of a building so fast he caught fire, similar to a spacecraft re-entering the atmosphere at approximately 17,000 miles per hour.
And he's even capable of taking out others just as overpowered as himself. Like his brother Virgil, who was not dead.
Sí, he visto que le iba a dar vergue.
He stopped a colossal punch from this titanic monster without breaking a sweat, shrugged off bombardment by meteors, and eventually avenged his mother by defeating the demon lord Mundus. In space.
Space. Portal.
Yes, Dante does have a limit to how much punishment he can take, but if there's anything that could take him down, it's his own cocky attitude.
In the words of the ancient Chinese philosopher Lao Tzu, there is no greater danger than underestimating your opponent.
I'm gonna have to disagree with old Lao Tzu here. Pretty sure there's no greater danger than telling a woman those fans do in fact make her ass look fat.
You bastard!
Die! Bayonetta.
From the angels of Paradiso to the demons of Inferno, there is a name feared by both the light and the dark, and her name is Bayonetta.
I thought they were extinct, but Lieutenant said that.
She may look like your average 7-foot-tall gargantuan Amazon woman with good fashion sense, but Bayonetta is actually one of the last Umbra witches, a clan of mystics allied with demonkind.
Named Cereza upon birth, she spent her early life growing up an outcast due to her parents being from rival clans. Her father, a Lumen Sage, and her mother, an Umbra Witch.
See, the sages and witches had one rule to follow. Don't make babies with the opposite clan because, according to prophecy, it would bring on the destruction of the universe. So, naturally, it was only a matter of time before somebody couldn't keep it in their pants. Pulling out works every time, but the last time.
You would know. With the pact now broken, war ensued between the two factions. In the end, only two witches survived, Cereza and her rival slash future friend, Jean. Hoping to prevent the apocalypse, Jean used a special dagger to seal away Cereza's memories and put her into a 500-year-long coma.
When Cereza woke up from her epic power nap, she took on her new name, Bayonetta.
Bayonetta.
Set out to find her lost memories. Luckily for her, she had just the right weapon for the job. Her hair,
as an Umbra witch,
no querrán joder.
Which I'm having a really hard time deciding whether or not that's hot or just disgusting.
She can also use it to summon the demon Madama Butterfly to aid her in battle. This technique, the Wicked Weeds, creates portals for the giant demon to deliver devastating punches and kicks.
Bayonetta can also walk on walls and ceilings with witch walk, and even transform into animals to fly, run super fast, and dodge attacks.
But her most useful
thing
is witch tongue. By slowing down
demasiado OP para Smash.
Bayonetta can dodge practically anything while unleashing a barrage of attacks.
Bayonetta is basically a tall, sexy armory. She wields gauntlets called Durga, which attack with fire and electricity. A huge sight that rots the souls of its victims, and a friggin' lightsaber called Pillar Tongue. She has a bow that fires poison arrows, a chainsaw made of dragon scales, a massive hammer that can cause earthquakes with every strike, and even ice skates, which is attacked with ice, obviously.
But her most beloved weapons are her four pistol set called Love is Blue. Rather than swap between them like a normal person, she somehow manages to wield all of them at once by using not only her hands, but also her feet.
How does that work? Thumbs on her ankles or something? That would be a distraction from the hot distractions. She's a monkey! Monkey witch!
Brujamo, no.
I highly doubt that. She probably just uses some sort of magic. Speaking of magic, when Bayonetta wants to unleash her full potential, she triggers her Umbran Climax.
Which increases
her strength and lets her summon Madama Butterfly's full unrestrained power. When fully unleashed, Madama Butterfly can shatter huge meteors by headbutting them.
Climax. By herself, Bayonetta has pulled off some impressive feats. She's strong enough to kick military jets into the air, headbutt skyscrapers across the city, and even throw satellites with her legs in outer space. Oh, by the way, she can survive outer space.
Todo el tiempo en espacio.
This thing is only a matter of real-time seconds. Even without which time, her reaction speed is astronomical. For example, when a Lumen Sage stopped time to position newly fired bullets about 3 feet behind her, she managed to not only turn and identify the incoming threat, but also dodge all 16 of them. Considering regular bullets travel around 2,500 feet per second, she must have pulled all that off in less than 1,000th of a second.
And then there's that one guy. When she killed God, scissoring her hair with shuns and punching the creator's soul across the entire solar system into the sun?
Okay, otra vez el sol.
Her abilities are absolutely ridiculous, but she is sometimes rather inconsistent.
Despite her reaction time, she's been caught off guard by enemies ranging from a half-god called Lobster, something like that, and even a plant monster that managed to grab her out of the air.
But regardless of whatever weaknesses she may have, Bayonetta's achieved more than anyone could possibly imagine despite being 100% human.
Wait, she is human?
Alright, let's dance.
Get done, one of us, with a witch.
Alright, the combatants are set. Let's end this debate once and for all.
But first, we made another video game and it sure would be swell if you buy it.
Pasamos al comercio. Mientras que estamos en el eso. Dante, Bayonetta tienen bastantes poderes, son ágiles. Me es difícil analizar comparado con Riz Greystar o algunos que me distraigo con ese comercial, no importa, pero vamos, Bayonetta va a ganar. Wish time, let's go, dash, vamos.
Another wandering lost soul, I see.
Whoa. Lost? Nah. I'm looking for something called a left eye. Care to give me a hand? Could be fun.
I see. But if you're looking for the left eye, that would either make you an angel.
Empezamos.
Or a demon.
Fight.
Get back.
Yo creo que Bayonetta va a ganar en esta, o tal vez Dante. Es difícil saberlo. No conozco bien todos sus juegos, honestamente. Quest time.
What a disappointing finish.
Surprise.
Looks like you're more of a man than I thought.
Come on.
change.
Sorry, but I gotta cancel your time stopping.
Haven't used this in a while. Still got it. In the mud.
You're a naughty boy hitting a girl like that. You need to be taught a lesson.
Now this is what I'm talking about.
You're gonna love this.
Wish climax. But I'm a butterfly. Dante.
Your breath stinks.
Revienta pesta. Dante derrotó a esta bestia. Tiempo.
This is where we part ways, love.
After you.
Trish?
Come on, Trish, you missed.
Oh, don't be a baby.
Creo que esto será dos contra dos. Ahora.
Cereza, having some guy trouble? Not to worry, I've got this one handled.
Wait, we're getting paid for this one, right?
Come on.
Va a ser difícil, más difícil ahora. Bye bye. La caja de Pandora. Los voy a matar a todos, Dante. Es como el intro de Bayonetta. El reloj. Esto se va a acabar ahora. Debe un trigger.
Pretty or not, don't fuck with a witch.
None. You do not want to. It's over. Adiós. Dante. Ya mataste a Bayonetta.
How come I never meet any nice girls?
Kayo, worst date ever.
Think, what happened to Trish and John? Are they still fighting?
Well, I'll show you how I think it went down in my new show, DBX.
Wait, what? Did you actually do analysis on your own?
Hell no. I'm just gonna make him bite.
Ugh, you would. In what actually matters, it's true that Bayonetta's satellite-throwing feat trumps any and all of Dante's physical displays of strength. However, Dante edges out in every other category.
His arsenal matched and exceeded Bayonetta's blow for blow. Hell, even a giant demon like Madonna Butterfly is nothing new to this demon slayer for hire. But well, Bayonetta didn't have many ways to actually kill him. I mean, the dude shrugs out mortal wounds every day like they were nothing more than bug bites. Both could take a bullet, but unlike Dante, when Bayonetta's stabbed, it hurts. That's why avoiding attacks was her specialty.
But she could only dodge for so long against somebody like Dante. Early in their career, Dante and Virgil obliterated each and every raindrop within a 12-foot radius, briefly creating a completely open space in a rainstorm. Up to 30 raindrops can occupy a cubic foot on average, meaning they destroyed 108,000 raindrops in a second. Without any extra abilities or
speed,
Dante strikes in so much space in so little time, far outclassing anything she has ever had to avoid.
Even when she tried avoiding him with quick time, Dante's quicksilver evened the play field, basically making it useless.
It was just a matter of time before Bayonetta suffered the fatal blow.
Well, you know what they say, hair today, gone tomorrow.
The winner,
Dante wins. A ver quién sigue ahora. Next time. Bowser. Será contra Eggman. Bueno, esta es la segunda reacción blank que hago. La primera que aún no he subido es esa de Chuck Norris contra Segata Sanshiro. La subiré a YouTube. Eso tendré que averiguar. Sayonara.